Hi everyone and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4 as China. So, let's continue where we left off and continue our war with the Soviet Union. It shouldn't take too much longer to reach Moscow. We aren't too far away. And not much else going on really. It's mostly us wrecking the Soviet Union. They are still trying to defend themselves, but they can't both defend themselves against us and against the Allies at the same time, and most of their army is on the Western Front. So yeah, I don't think this will take much longer. Having said that, we're still a good bit away from Moscow, and taking Moscow alone will not be enough. I still want to nuke them at some point. We should have enough time, I hope. We only need 30 days to finish strategic bomber research, and we'll get a nuke in 82 days. So yeah, we should be able to nuke them without any problems. And that will also reduce their national unity, which should help end the war faster. They are currently at 61%. Alright, so let's check our progress. How are we doing? We seem to be doing okay. Right, and our newest army is going to help in the west. That's pretty much why they are here. Which means they are going to need their own battle plan. So, we can start it in Stalingrad. Yeah, something like this. And we'll go towards Moscow. Yep, that's pretty much it. And likely wait for the planning bonus. House supply. Yeah, we could actually use some extra supply down here, I guess. Let's queue up some. And in this region too. Actually, no, that's not necessary. Yeah, that's not necessary. Construction. And to the bottom of the list. Let's remove this real quick. And redo. Okay, and try this again. That's two regions. Three regions? Yeah, I think that's actually three regions. Yeah, that's three different regions. Alright. We'll build up some infrastructure. And I think that's enough for now. Yeah, that should be enough. How long will it take? Should be around 25 days. It will actually be done this year. At least the first one will be. Yeah, the first two will be done this year. Good enough. So let's wait for that planning bonus. It shouldn't take too long. Alright then. And we can do a few attacks manually to make it a little bit faster. How are we doing in the east? Let's take a look. We can still capture some more territory. Is this one big region? No. That's four different regions. Alright. We'll just do it like this. And send the other guys west. No need to stay here. That's silly. Off you go, people. And we can move manually a bit. That will make things faster. Looking good. Same story here. Just take a few provinces. I'm surprised they are not doing it on their own, but whatever. I guess we'll do it manually. Well, actually, yeah, we do not have a battle plan here. Should probably make one. Bulgaria has capitulated. Look at all the United Kingdom territory in Europe. They took a lot. How's our participation score? 15%. I mean, that's not terrible, all things considered. But we likely won't be able to take everything that we conquered. That seems unlikely. Not that it really matters once we win this war. It's basically game over. Also, paratroopers. Where are the paratroopers? Right here. So, we could create a plan. Might be a good idea. But I'll have to remove one of the air wings. Not really a problem. Remove that one and get some transports. We don't need 100 transports. 50 will be enough. 50 will be way too many, but whatever. Okay, and I assume we have air superiority. That shouldn't be a problem at all. At least in every region where we actually have fighters. Yeah, we don't have any fighters here. But we could send some. Here's the closest airbase. So we can deploy 2 air wings of 100 fighters. Okay, and we'll send them to Central Russia. That should be enough to get air superiority. They don't actually have anything here, so yeah, it will be enough. And we could actually paradrop into Moscow. That would be pretty funny. But yeah, we can do it. Oh, supply? No, supply seems fine, just a little bit of attrition. They are still moving. So the battle plan will have to wait a moment or two. We should probably move a little bit closer, but it shouldn't matter too much. I might have to move a little bit closer. But first we'll check if this airport is good enough. So pause for a moment. And let's have a look. What's the range? Yeah, we have to move a little bit closer. That's fine. Strategic redeployment. We'll just use the Stalingrad airbase. That's perfectly fine. Yep, that's perfectly fine. And actually just move that air wing. And we can deploy, let's say, 70 fighters and then 30 transports. Or 80 fighters and 20 transports. There, that's good enough. Is that air wing redeploying or what? It should be. That was the airbase. Let's try that again. Yeah, they didn't deploy to this airbase yet. Well, screw it, just remove it. That's going to be faster. Just checking. Yeah, remove the transports. I was looking at the wrong airbase. And deploy some more fighters. 100 fighters. Okay, looking good. Yeah, Central Russia is a little bit too far away. Okay, now we just wait. I don't think we'll be close enough to actually paradrop into Moscow, but we can paradrop as close as possible. That's the plan. Are there any other airbases in this area? Doesn't look like it. Just this one, near Stalingrad. Are you guys moving? Come on, faster. Oh yeah, strategic bomber. Right, now we have to build that. And what else do we want to research? Let's see. Jet engines. radar station. Not much point researching radar station. Oh yeah, and I can't actually get rocket engines or jet engines yet. Alright. Industry. Excavation 4, that's fine. And take some more land. And we're here, alright. Let's create the battle plan. How far can we go? We can get pretty damn close to Moscow. Now, this is a little bit risky. I wouldn't be doing something like this normally, but we are winning the war decisively. So we can afford to do something slightly crazy. And I've not been doing much with the paratroopers anyway. So we'll do it. Actually, hold on. Will we have enough? Yeah, okay, let's not move into a completely different air region. Yeah, we'll redo. We'll drop somewhere in central Russia. So again. Like this. That should be central Russia. And remove the other plan. Yep. Okay, looks good. That's central Russia. Yep. But no divisions assigned, just need to do it manually. There, 15 paratroopers assigned. And now we just wait. Advanced computing machine. Alright. Encryption and decryption. I assume we have air superiority. Yes, we do. House supply. Still a bit of a problem. Yeah, let's improve it a little bit. We're in January. Move it to the front of the queue. Alright. The Allies aren't making a whole lot of progress, and we've been crushing Russia in the east. We will take Moscow long before they get anywhere close to it. We took so much land. Alright, carry on then. And you guys? How about you do something useful? Thanks. And take more land. Yeah, you there. Do something useful. Don't just stand there. I'm not even going to bother creating a new battle plan. There's no need. We just need to grab Moscow and some victory points in the west. Or we'll just draw one big battle plan in the east. We can also do that. Actually, that's not a bad idea. We can do something like this. There, that's 41 divisions. And we can just draw one huge offensive line. Yeah, something like this, basically. To take everything. Sure, whatever works. This looks a little bit funny. I don't think that's exactly what I intended. No, not really, it's not. Then again, it's actually fine. It's just that the arrow looks a little bit funny. But it's fine. Okay, execute. And let's send the paratroopers. Off you go. This should make things a little bit faster, to say the least. Hopefully. We shouldn't have any problems actually getting there. So are you guys going? They don't have full organization, which is a bit of a problem, but they will be fine. I guess they are on the way. That's not the transport, is it? No. Okay, there they are. Now, let's pause for a moment and spread out manually. Just take as much as possible while we have organization, you know? And before anyone attacks us. Yep, just take everything around us. And we'll create a battle plan. We'll push towards our own front line. That's basically the plan here. So let's start moving more. Come on, people, move. You guys are slow. Yeah, their organization is a little bit low. And more research is done. Let's have a look. What do we need? Nothing special. We can get slightly better paratroopers. Are they actually going to take anything? Because they are taking massive attrition. Yeah, they will take a few provinces at least. Organization. Obviously, we are out of supply. It's snowing and deep snow. I mean, it is January in Russia. So that's not exactly surprising. Yep, they are coming. This should be a decent distraction, actually. Let's maybe push a little bit harder. Come on, people. Let's go. We'll try to send one division like this. Alright, well, this will definitely distract the Soviets. Again, I normally wouldn't do something like this, because this is silly. But this game is basically done. So we can afford to do something slightly silly. Yeah, let's just push towards them. With at least a division or two. Preferably more than one. Yep, these guys. Come on. I think they will be okay, but I suppose we'll find out. We can split up a little bit. We are already getting surrounded. Hey, we actually won a fight. That's amazing. Are their divisions really that bad? Yeah, possibly. We are almost out of organization. But it's okay, reinforcements are coming. So the cavalry is on the way, or in this case, artillery. And no one is stopping us so far. Yep, we will get there just fine. We aren't even being attacked right now, only in the north, and we are winning that fight, surprisingly enough. Yeah, their division is just awful, so I guess that explains it. I still don't have enough intel to actually see their division makeup. Okay, we are on the way. And we are also getting some help. We can take a few provinces on the way. And we linked to our territory. So it actually kind of worked. And we are only, what, 4 provinces away from Moscow? It won't take long. And now we are actually getting supply in here. We are not the state owner just yet. All the supply is at least in the yellow. Looking good. We can improve the infrastructure slightly. Because we don't have anything better to do anyway. Like so. Alright. So. Let's just push manually. A little bit. This way. Would be nice to become the state owner up here. Then we could maybe improve the infrastructure slightly. Push from the other direction. Organization should be going up. Yep, it's going up slightly. And we can grab a province maybe. We should be able to, yeah. We are actually winning that fight. With like 1/4 organization. If not lower than that. That's amazing. Yeah, they are out of organization as well. Alright, that explains a lot. Any air bases around here? I'm not seeing any. Alright, kill these encircled guys. How's the war score now? What's the percentage? 57%, yeah, we'll obviously need more victory points, not just Moscow. But Moscow is worth the most, 50 victory points. So we'll grab Moscow and then take as many victory points in the area as possible. Once we attack them from the back, their western front line will completely collapse. And it shouldn't take too long to grab everything with the Allies' help. Yeah, their front line in the south is already collapsing. Looking good! And how are we doing in the east? We're not moving too quickly, from the looks of it. Alright. Grab a few provinces manually. No one is actually defending them. Oh yeah, night vision. That is actually helpful. Night vision too. Oh, and also, I didn't actually start strategic bombers. Might want to do that. Because we are going to need at least one. We'll move it to the front of the production queue. Yeah, almost two strategic bombers per week. We'll nuke them, if only to reduce their national unity. We are 98% towards our first nuke. We only need air superiority, which is easy enough. We could still nuke Moscow before we take it. Where's the closest airbase? Probably the one near Stalingrad. Is that one close enough? I think it's close enough. But we'll need... No, we already have air superiority, because that's central Russia. Yeah, let's just nuke Moscow then. Why the heck not? We don't need the transports anymore. Just the strategic bombers. The nuke is done. Alright, give me the strategic bomber. It should be done in like 3 days? 4 days? Kill these encircled guys. And let's keep pushing. They actually still have armored divisions. That's almost impressive. But not quite. Yeah, kill that armored division. House organization? Kind of poor. Are we the state owner here? Yes, we are. So that means we can improve infrastructure slightly. Probably not necessary, but might as well do it. We don't have anything better to do with our civilian factories anyway. Alright. So, how's that strategic bomber? Should be ready by now. Just going to pause for a moment, because that makes the game run a little bit better. Where's the strategic bomber? There it is, 3 strategic bombers, good enough. We don't need more than that. Just need to wait for them to deploy, and then we can nuke Moscow. I'm mostly doing it for the national unity effect. Come on, people, deploy faster. Expected arrival. Oh, they need 6 days to deploy? Alright, fine. Whatever. We won't get to Moscow in 6 days anyway. We might actually need some extra infrastructure. Or just wait to regain organization. We are getting a little bit of attrition. Okay. And yeah, low supply. How's recruitment? Do we have any new divisions? Yeah, all the way in Beijing. Yeah, we do have a few new divisions. Okay. We'll send them to Stalingrad or so. It will take them a while to actually arrive there. We might even take Moscow by the time they arrive here, even with strategic redeployment. Okay, the strategic bomber is there, so we can nuke Moscow now, I think. Can we not nuke Moscow yet? Yes, we can nuke Moscow. Incoming fireworks. Almost there. Here it comes. Nice. Always satisfying to nuke someone, doesn't matter what game it is. And that will lower their national unity. Atomic bombing of Moscow. A city many have tried and failed to conquer. Moscow was the target of a nuclear attack today. The explosion was directed at the heart of the Soviet leadership, the Kremlin, having been nearly completely destroyed by the blast. Joseph Stalin, having grown more aware and fearful of all possible and impossible threats recently, evacuated in time and survived. However, even the vastness of Soviet Union may not be enough to escape such a ruthless enemy. Indeed, if this continues, the nation will soon consist of only two kinds of wastelands, those which were there in the first place and those created by its enemies. I like that. So let's check the war score now. They have 54% of victory points and will capitulate at 44% or less. We could just nuke them one more time once we get a new nuke, and that will likely be enough to make them capitulate. We might not even have to take Moscow. Yeah, that is a real possibility. I will nuke them one more time if we finish the nuke. We will finish it in 73 days. But we are about to get some reinforcements. They are probably not even halfway there, I imagine. Yeah, they are not even halfway there. Time to remove these fighters and bombers. They don't have anything to do back here. The game definitely slows down quite significantly with such a long front line and so much going on. Okay, let's just pause for a moment. That makes it a little bit better. That makes it much better. And these guys as well. Yeah, they are too far away at this point. Okay, looks good. And we can deploy a few up here. 100 bombers and 100 fighters. Doesn't matter which. Yep, looks good. And which region is that going to be? This one, I guess. Good enough. Yep, we are still fighting there, so that's fine. Come on, people. Push towards Moscow. It's not winter anymore, so I'm sure you can do it. ...24% towards the next nuke. House organization, it's at 100%. And we're done with experimental rockets. Right, we should create a battle plan for the paratroopers. So let's do that real quick. First of all, front line. We'll just push towards Moscow, basically. So there. We'll get a planning bonus. And then just execute. Don't even have to wait for the planning bonus, actually. Yep, just execute the plan right away. And we can set it to aggressive, because why not? These divisions are not nearly as good as my main template, but they are fine. I just need them to make some progress. Shouldn't be too hard, it's not like the Soviet Union has a lot of troops to throw at us at this point, and they are still busy defending their Western Front. 33%, yeah, we'll take Moscow before we get another nuke. Shouldn't take too long. Let's just move manually a bit more. Like so. And another victory point. How much is this one worth? Only 3 victory points, but we'll grab it anyway. just in case we'll need more than just Moscow. Any more victory points in the south? Yes. Only one victory point. Oh yeah, 10 victory points. Okay, let's push. We can take that quite easily. We can just tell our guys to go right there. So we'll tell them to do exactly that. Okay, looking good. Back to Moscow. Come on, people. Fight harder. I'm sure you can manage it. ...42%. We might get a chance to nuke it one more time. But at that point, I would probably nuke a different city. Any different city. Not much point nuking a city that I'm literally about to take. Yes, keep moving. What are you waiting for? How's that victory point in the south? We're about to take it. Sounds good. Yep, it's about to be ours. It's already ours. ...51%. Moscow might actually end the war. We'll find out. ...50%. If Moscow doesn't end the war, the next nuke definitely will. And yeah, we got one more victory point on the way. Not worth a whole lot, but always something. ...5 points, 10 points, 10 points. And an airbase. Not that we really need one, but alright. We can always deploy some fighters and bombers if we want to. I don't think it's really necessary. But let's do it regardless. Still only 200 up here. They need to build better airbases, but a little bit too late for that now. And tactical bombers. That's enough. Looking good. 56% towards the nuke. We are literally about to take Moscow. Come on, people, one final push. And Moscow will be ours. Go, go, go. Surprise artillery. The worst kind of artillery. Almost there. 28, 80, 83, 86, 90. And it's ours. So, will it end the war or do we need some more? We will probably need more. But that's fine. Again, we'll just nuke one more time. Let's have a look. 41%. It was actually enough. So, this should start a peace conference. A pretty damn big one, though. Yeah, I got some event, but I clicked it a little bit too fast. I was going to close the other window, and it popped on top of my cursors. Anyway... Change government, okay. Interesting. The true path of democracy, uh-huh. Okay, then. So... Yeah, Mongolia. What can we actually do? We can't do a whole lot right now. Yeah, I can't spend too much, unfortunately. I could pass my round. I mean, it's not like the United Kingdom and such will take any land in the Far East Asia. That seems very unlikely. Okay. So, pass one more time. They will almost definitely focus on Europe, because, you know, that's what they have been conquering. Okay. Seems good. Let's pass one more time. And now we can start taking stuff. So, let's do that. We'll just take as much land as possible over here. Probably won't be able to take too much. We don't have enough points for that. But these provinces are not worth a whole lot. Yeah, 1 point. We can take all these provinces in the Far East because they are barely worth anything and they are huge. So we can be visually much bigger. That's always nice. Because, you know, that's the number one goal in any Paradox game. Make your name the biggest it can possibly be. Unfortunately, Mongolia will kind of block that, which is highly unfortunate. Anyway, more. Yeah, we can actually take most of the Soviet Union right now. Okay. Sure, let's do that. We can actually get a border with Finland. Yeah, we can do that. We can take Leningrad. Perfect! We'll have a port. Okay, more. And wait, can we take Moscow? Right now? I'm not sure. It's kind of hard to see with all this green. That's like way too much green. Yeah. It's actually a little bit ridiculous. But I think we can take Moscow. Yeah, we can take Moscow. And some more. I still have enough. Okay, we still have enough. Another naval base. We can almost take Königsberg. We can actually take Königsberg. Okay, now I have to give up one region. This one? No, that's a pretty big one. What do we want to give up? One of these. Okay, hold on. Yeah, that's a huge one. We can take this later, I guess. Alright, we'll take this later. So, no, that's not enough points. Again. But I want Königsberg. Alright, we'll give up one. That's still not enough points. Okay, end turn. That's much better. Alright, now we can take more. Let's take as much as possible in the west, because the allies will grab that for sure. We can take Danzig. That's pretty funny. Chinese Danzig or Gdańsk. How many points can we spend? We can still spend a bit. Not much more. Alright. We could focus on the coastal provinces. This is kind of hilarious. Yeah, this looks good. I like it. Poznań. Nope. Can't afford that one. Never mind. Nope, can't afford that either. 12 points. 15 points, 10 points. Alright, next. Another round. We have a border with... No, we don't have a border with France, but we have a border with the Netherlands, which is kind of hilarious. Can we take Luxembourg? Yeah, we actually can. Well, not Luxembourg itself, but land right next to it. So now we have a border with Luxembourg and with France. We can actually get a border with Switzerland. Okay. More? We might be getting a little bit too greedy in Europe. Yeah, let's grab some more land in Asia. On the next round. Alright, let's just grab the rest of the land in Asia at this point. We'll let them take some land in Europe. So, like this. like so. Some to the south? Yeah, maybe. Okay. Good enough, next round. We'll take Crimea. And maybe cut them off. Like this. This is totally unnecessary, by the way. Because this is basically game over. I could just ignore the peace conference, but that's the fun part. Alright, hold on. I think we can take some more provinces in Europe. Let's have a look. Yep, we certainly can. We can actually take a few in Italy and have direct land access. That's hilarious. What are they even doing with their points right now? Okay. Piedmont. This is actually kind of hilarious. And we did this with what? Around 15%? We probably had a lot more. Especially after the nuke. But I don't think we had more than maybe 20% participation. Mostly because we joined their war that has been going on for a pretty long time. Or we merged the wars. So it's understandable that we wouldn't have a super high percentage. Okay. I think it's just us in the conference now. Nope, that's too much. That's still too much. Oh no, it's not just us. Okay, and some more down here. This is going to take a while, from the looks of it. We're not quite done. That's a lot of border gore. Let's grab a few cheap provinces in here. Really? That's not enough points? Okay. 19. 31. Nope. Well, this is some hardcore border gore. I'll let them grab some. Let's pass one round. Let them take some stuff. Okay. Not much left. We can take some Turkey, I suppose. Probably not a whole lot. Yeah, that's... yeah, we can take most of Turkey, actually. Sure. Why not? Are we actually done now? Surely, we have to be almost done by now. I can still take Italy. Let's pass. Okay. Not much else left. I mean, we can just grab some Italy, I suppose. I wasn't planning to. Okay, we'll take all of that. Why the heck not? Done. There's nothing else left. Well, I took a lot more than I expected to. That was a pretty good peace conference for us, I would say. Treaty of Budapest. Let's see, Hellenic Republic took 2 states, the US only took 3. We took 188. Alright. The Democratic Party, Democratic, what? Okay, the Democratic Party, Democratic has been put in power in Xinjiang Independent Republic. That's a very awkward sentence. Same here. Okay. So they just wanted to spread democracy. I'm okay with that. I'll take the land and you can spread democracy. So they basically didn't really take any stays at all. It was mostly us. They just wanted to spread democracy. Sure! And that's that. We are controlling most of Asia. And a pretty big part of Europe. I didn't expect to take this much in Europe. Let's check our production. These are all our resources. Construction, 316 civilian factories. And 336 military factories. That's a lot of military factories. The games. Alright, in Tokyo. Well, anyway, I guess that's going to be the end of this series. We finished the war on the winning side. And we took a lot of crap. So I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.